a church summer camp called EFY when we were 16. And we really connected and we became really good friends, and he definitely was the cutest boy there.
So a week after EFY, Nikki ended up coming down to Vegas and we had our first date. So we went out to got a little bite to eat, and one of the coolest things about it was just the way that we connected. It was just something unique that I've never really experienced before. Just really connected the whole time throughout it.
After my trip to Las Vegas, and we kind of drifted apart, just being in different states, being in high school, we just weren't able to stay as close as we wanted, even though we connected. We had a year and a half or so of not talking at all, and then one day, I got this text message from James, and he said, "Hey, whenever you get a chance, give me a call." So I did, and we ended up talking for literally 4 hours. And I was expecting at the end of the phone call, like, "Hey, talk to you another 6 months," or something like that. But he said, "Can I call you tomorrow?" And I said, "Okay."
So we started talking just tons, just every day, just for hours, just talking about life. We actually just became really good friends during this time period. And this friendship ended up growing and getting, you know, more serious, and eventually turned into a relationship that we kind of didn't expect. I was preparing for my mission, just different things, but it ended up turning into something great. And eventually, Nikki came up that summer to BYU for that term. And we just had an amazing summer, just spent tons of time together and really just had a wonderful time, just an amazing summer.
Got his mission call. We expected to just drift apart, and we had the attitude of whatever happens, happens. We did not expect at all to be waiting for each other, but it didn't exactly happen that way.
So I get my mission call to Russia, and while I was out there, we of course expected that things were going to die out, just cool down, but it turns out that we stayed friends, and we ended up growing. Our friendship actually grew, and she ended up being a really great support to me throughout my whole mission.
And then he came home, and although it felt really long during the process, once we were back together, it just felt like he never left. Even though we were different and we were different people, we felt right back in the place.
And after several months of dating, we decided that it was time to progress in our relationship. And I decided that it was time to propose. So we have a little spot, a little special place for us in Las Vegas. And I ended up taking her to Las Vegas, and we spent that weekend with my family. And I snuck out while she was napping one day, and I went and spelled out with rocks, "Marry me," and was able to get back home without her even noticing.
Later on that day, I knew something was up by the way James was acting. He took me to one of our special places in Las Vegas, and we went on a walk in this park. As we got further on into our walk, he handed me the flashlight, and I saw that the rocks were formed in some sort of formation. So I looked over it, and I saw the words "Marry Me" on them. And I turn over to look at him, and he's on one knee, and he has my ring in his hand, and he asks, "Marry me?" And I said yes.
We absolutely love each other, and I'm so excited for our future together. She's just my sweetheart, and I love her to death.
He truly is my best friend, and I am so excited to be best friends with him forever.
And I'm so excited to be with her for the rest of eternity.